Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to recap a little bit more on aligner tracking and Invisalign tracking, clear correct tracking, pick your aligner, any aligners, they all work the same in terms of tracking. I've made quite a few videos on this before, suggestions, I have a lot of paperwork forms. If you want to watch everything I've already made on this topic, I recommend that you go to my YouTube channel. To get there, go to your YouTube channel, put in the search bar at the top, Straight Smile Solutions. From there, you're in my YouTube channel, which has a green banner. There's a tiny magnifying glass in the top right. You can go ahead and put a keyword in like tracking, and it'll show you all the videos I've made over the last few years on tracking. Tons of tricks and tips. So today is just going to be a high level overview, how to optimize your tracking, and it's really not rocket science. Of course, the first thing you have to do is you got to pick an appropriate case. If you don't pick an appropriate case, things aren't going to work out, right? Second thing you got to do is you need to make sure that you've staged it correctly and that the mechanics are correct. You cannot just trust a technician. I can't say this enough times. 99.999 times when I see a case, I know it's probably not going to work out because it's not done right. Technicians are not orthodontists trained in the US. Sorry that they're not. They might have an orthodontist on their team, but they're not trained in the US. And you know what? Their ultimate goal is to lower the overhead as much as possible and sell the cases on their end, not to optimize your treatment plan. That's just how it is. They want to save money. They're going to try to shortchange you. I'm sorry. Even the best aligner companies do this. And if you talk to any orthodontist, they never go with the first ClinCheck. First of all, they usually take, I mean, 3, 4, 5 tries to optimize it. And they usually, they're, goodness, lots of changes that we make. So you need to learn how to do this, or you need to partner with an orthodontist to do it for you. That's my suggestion. One or the other. My suggestion is to do both. Initially, to partner with an orthodontist to help you out. Then you'll learn how to do it and you can take it from there. So anyways, how to improve aligner and Invisalign tracking. So first suggestion that I have is you need to understand what tracking is. What is tracking? Tracking is only going to happen if your ClinCheck or your treatment plan is optimized. So if it's not possible and not predictable, you're not going to get it, right? So let's say I worked on your ClinCheck and it's optimized. Now I know it's possible. Second major thing we need to do is we need to manage the patient's compliance. So now if it's optimized, this is pretty much idiot proof. As long as the patient keeps it in their mouth 22 hours a day, I mean, barring an occasional pathology or weird thing that happens and occasionally strange things happen, but 99 times out of 100, if the patient keeps it in their mouth as directed 22 hours a day, that doesn't mean 20, that doesn't mean 18, that means 22. 22 is tough. I mean, I'll be honest. I've had aligners, my daughter has aligners, 22 can be tough. People have a lot of habits where they're taking things out and they're snacking and they're drinking their coffee, and that 2 hours out adds up very, very quickly. So it really is kind of a lifestyle change for the patient. Now, there's workarounds and there's ways you can do this so that they can leave them in while they eat, but I'm not talking about this. I'm going with the 22 hours thing. That's a whole nother conversation. If you want to watch that video, you can find that in my Invisalign channel. So basically, your patient needs to understand it has to be worn 22 hours a day. Aligners are meant to fit like a wetsuit, hence the wetsuit guy here. They should be never, ever any space between the aligner and the tooth. See here, poor tracking. And this is like a severe poor tracking. This is off by many aligners. This is not just a minor poor tracking. My scripting, if you've worked with me before, I've said this so many times, it just like comes out. Put in your first aligner. Use your chewies, chew it down for about 15 minutes the first time you put it in. Of course, you always wanna do this after you've brushed your teeth before you go to bed. Put your aligner in, chew it down, go to sleep, get up in the morning, peek around, look with a flashlight. If you see any, even micro gaps between the aligner and the tooth, it should look like this, not at all even close to like this. No micro gaps, not even a tiny little one. That, nothing like that. Then you need to keep chewing it down. You get 72 hours to chew it down, 72 hours, 3 days to keep working on the chewing. If you can't get it to be fully flush against the tooth like a wetsuit, you need to go back to your previous aligner and wear it one more week. Of course, if you are on aligner number one and you can't get it down, then you need to go back for another refinement or a warranty fit correction. There's something wrong with the manufacturing. Something was wrong with the treatment plan, okay? But assuming you're on 2 or above, if you can't get it seated within 72 hours, you need to go back and wear the previous one another week. Hence this little storage box here. It says, please change your aligners every 7 days. Use your chewies three times a day for, I said 20 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever, for the first 3 days after the aligner change to help seat the aligner. If there are any spaces between the tooth and the aligner that can't be eliminated with the Chewies after 48 hours, I think I said 72, but whatever, please go back to the previous aligner and wear it another week. Then try to advance again. If the aligner still isn't tracking after that, please give us a call. Stay in your old aligner. Do not advance. The other thing I want to mention is that normally my ClinCheck are 7-day wears. These are ones that I've slowed down and optimized. The ones that you get defaults from Invisalign, no comment. So that 7 days doesn't start until you get it seated. So if it takes you 2 days to get it seated, you're now wearing that aligner 9 days. So 7 days is a gray area. It's minimum 7 days. It might be more, okay? Sure, you can tell your patients to wear it 10 days or 14 days, but I don't feel like, first of all, that's often unnecessary. You're wasting time. Second of all, I don't feel like you're educating your patient on the process because now they're just, you know, rotely changing their aligners every 10 days or 14 days, and they're not focusing what they need to focus on, which is the tracking. So if you empower the patient with an accountability loop on the tracking, have them save all their old aligners so you can mark this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or at least the last 5 aligners in a little box that you can give them. You can buy these from Amazon, Walmart, whatever, super cheap. You know, you can buy smaller ones too. You don't have to have, you know, 15 slots or something like that. But definitely they need to save at least their last 5. Bring it into every appointment. That way, if they come in and it's not fitting 100%, you're gonna go ahead, whip out the old aligners, find the one that fits. So maybe now you're on 13 upper and 11 lower, that's fine. Just slow down your lower wear to catch up with the upper. Don't keep going the same speed. Eventually, we want them to be caught up, and you should be fine. If you get really stuck and you can't find the right fit and it's still not tracking, well, then you have to do the refinement revision, whatever you wanna call it, mid-course correction. That's pretty much it. It's not rocket science. It's really, really easy. If you do all this, and if your manufacturing is good, and if your ClinCheck or setup was optimized, and if your patient does their part, you should have no revisions, refinements on any cases. It should be a very, very rare one-off. And I like to talk about what is your revision or refinement rate. There is an analytics tab that they did show us in an Invisalign webinar, and they showed us what it looks like and how you can show your rate. However, I can't seem to find a way to enroll in that, nor can I find any more information, nor does anyone from Invisalign ever answer this question when I try to ask it multiple times. So if you do work for Invisalign Corporate, and I know y'all listen to my videos, hey, this analytics tab is brilliant. Bring it back. Make it easy for us to find and to opt into, or just make it default. Because I really, really think, and I'm going to keep saying this until it happens, because 9 times out of 10, when I tell Invisalign I want something, guess what? It shows up within a year. Is it from me or are they just smart? I don't know. Probably both. But the analytics tab is brilliant. Everyone should know what their revision refinement rate is. Revision refinements are not normal. Last webinar I went on that Invisalign hosted, they said 72% of their doctors have one or less refinements. Well, that means nothing to me, because if a refinement isn't normal, I would like to see 72% have zero refinements, you know? So one or less, and then they're not even factoring in, like, is this a moderate case? Did the patient discontinue? Well, of course you're gonna have one or less in a moderate case or a light case, because you don't get any, or you only get one, right? So that's the most absurd statistic I've ever heard. It was so badly done, I was just laughing. It's one of those things that makes them sound good, but it's so BS. Like, break it up. I only wanna know for comprehensive, and a lot of comprehensive cases, they don't finish. Patients stop, they quit, so that really shouldn't be factored into it. I think they should say, with ideal outcomes, how many percentage had a revision refinement. Now that's the stat I wanna listen to. I wanna see the final. Oh yeah, looks like it should have. That looks perfect. Okay, how many refinements did it take the patient, the doctor, to get there? If it took them one or less, okay, I'm somewhat impressed then. So anyways, that's everything I know about an aligner and Invisalign tracking. Listen, it works for me. The cases that I've worked on before usually have a very low to no refinement rate, less than 10%. Assuming the patient is doing what they're doing. And also, I forgot to mention, you definitely need to use Invisalign Virtual or some other virtual check-in process, whether you're creating your own, whether you're doing Align Flow, whether you're doing DM, dental monitoring, whether you're using Invisalign Virtual. I don't care what company you use. There's plenty that are out there, but you need to use it. But Invisalign Virtual has been optimized. It is free with your Invisalign cases. There's a patient-facing app. I've already done tons of content on that, as well as a doctor-facing dashboard. I have it on my phone. It's actually really easy, and they send you a notification whenever your patient checks in. Sorry for DM. I like dental monitoring, but guess what? Whenever you create something that's good, Someone is going to copy it. And anyways, the Invisalign Virtual does not have the AI that DM has. So there's definitely certain benefits to DM that's out there. I have no problem with DM. I love Felipe and his team. It's a brilliant product. It has lots of implications. But, you know, it's not affordable for the average doctor, especially a general dentist who's just getting started. It's just not affordable. It makes sense for the orthodontist. And I know that Candid and some other direct-to-consumer companies are using DM. That's great. I think that's absolutely fantastic, and I'm all up for that. So, but yeah, you need to be checking in every single aligner from home. It makes sense. Yes, it takes you 10 seconds as a doctor to look at the pictures and then to tell them to go ahead and proceed. But you know what? If you do that, you won't have revisions and refinements, which is going to save you money. Now that Invisalign's charging extra for refinements, you have a little extra fee every time you do it. I think in all countries now. As well as the time it takes you to take that scan, possibly to take the buttons off, possibly to put the buttons on, depending if you need more, and chair time as well, and the patient's time. And you know what? Patients are way more satisfied when they don't have refinements. They're much more likely to refer you other people, because the first thing other people ask is, how long did it take? And if they're like, oh man, it took 2 years, well, that's BS. No Invisalign case should be really taking that long unless it's an extentation case or an extraordinarily difficult surgical case. And granted, I've had those, so I get it. But the average case should not be taking 2 years. All right, thanks so much.